Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if it is your first time visiting. So this video I'm very excited to film because I have been waiting for fall to arrive, because some of these are in my top fragrances, and for me personally they are fragrances that mostly I wouldn't wear throughout spring and summer. There is a little bit of a theme going on here in the types of scents that I like to wear in the fall time, which you'll see as we get started. But yeah, if you couldn't already tell by the title, today I'm going to be filming my top 10 autumn fragrances. I'm very excited about this one. Like I said, my favourite category, and there are some big heavy hitters in here, in my opinion. So before we get started, it would be great if you could subscribe to my channel and like this video. Of course, if you like the content, I appreciate your support. So without further ado, let's get started. Now, the first one, I've kind of put these in a category almost, like bulked them together in their types of scent profile. The majority of them are of a similar nature, and the first two are in the kind of similar realms too. So the first fragrance is one of my all-time favourites. I absolutely adore this, and I talked about it in my first ever video actually, and that is none other than Stefan Humbert Lucas Venom Incarnate. And this is just my baby. This is probably my signature scent right now. I absolutely adore it. If I could kind of say what I feel like is me in a bottle and describes the kind of scents I like, this would be it. So Venom Incarnate is super sexy in my opinion. It's a mixture of kind of strawberries, berries and leather mostly. Obviously there's more notes in there, and what I'm actually going to do in this video is I am going to pop the notes up in this corner so you can see all of them rather than me reading everything out. But I am going to read some notes, of course. So I've got them here, and the top notes are wild strawberry, strawberry, caramel, middle notes, raspberry and cinnamon, and base notes, leather and tonka bean. And if you have not checked this out and you like the sound of these notes, I highly recommend checking it out. Like I said, Venom Incarnate is my baby, it is sexy, and this is gonna be perfect for autumn and winter. Next up on the list is Ilum by So Oud. And this one is a little bit harder to find, but you can find it. I will pop the link below. And it is of a similar nature to Venom Incarnate. Some slightly different notes in there. But yeah, I absolutely adore this, and I have been waiting for autumn winter to come around so I could actually make the most of this, because I did actually pick it up in springtime. And for me personally, it was a little bit heavy to wear throughout those seasons. And this was actually recommended to me by one of my friends on Instagram, and I thank him for that because it is a beautiful, beautiful scent. It's within the scent profiles that I tend to gravitate towards, which are kind of like the red berries or strawberries with a caramel and a leather note. So let me read you some of the notes for this one. So top notes, caramel, red berries and saffron. Middle notes, pink pepper, leather and ginger. And then in the base we have oud and vanilla. So this one is the more, not necessarily more potent version of Venom Incarnate, but it's the deeper and richer version. So it has obviously the oud note in it, which makes it very, very sexy. But I also think this will be really appropriate to wear on a date night, in the evenings, in the fall and winter. And yeah, this is highly, highly recommended. If you like fragrances like La Capitale, Venom Incarnate, then I highly recommend you getting your nose on Ilum if you can. So yeah, that is number two. The third on my list, so we're starting to move more into the kind of smoky or the vanilla or ambery scents now. So number three on my list, and I do only have a little small bottle of this, but I do plan on getting the full size, and that is Matière Première Encens Suave. It's a really cute bottle actually. I think this is 6 mils, so you can see I've used a little bit of it, but again, I picked this up in the spring and I think this is more of a fall winter scent, and this is absolutely gorgeous. It has notes of vanilla and incense, and I believe there's actually a coffee note in there too. And whenever I smell this on someone, I'm just blown away by how beautiful it is. And I think this is a no-brainer scent if you haven't got your nose on it. Totally unisex, very sexy too. So let's read some of the notes. Yeah, top notes coffee, so I thought it had coffee in it. Middle notes, incense and vanilla, and base notes are benzoin and labdanum. So yeah, this is just gorgeous. Highly hype, highly recommend. So on to number four, and number four on the list is one again that I picked up in spring and summer that I haven't really gotten enough wear out of, but is a beautiful, beautiful scent. It is talked about quite a lot on Instagram, and I have seen some reviews of it on YouTube too, and that is none other than Nashane Annie. And you can see I've got this big old bottle and I've barely been able to wear it. I think this one again is best in the autumn winter, and I've been looking forward to wearing it. So this is so, so stunning. And it's in that same category of kind of like the spicy amber vanilla scents, but this is very unique. It's got quite a complex note breakdown, which I'll go through. But yeah, totally unisex again, but it's very, very special. So the notes in this one are top notes, ginger, pink pepper and bergamot. Middle notes, cardamom and blackcurrant, and base notes, vanilla, benzoin, sandalwood and ambergris. And the ginger and cardamom in this are divine. It's kind of leaning gourmand, but it's nice and spicy, very rich, lasts a long time and projects like a beast. So highly recommend Nashane Annie. And the bottles are beautiful, very, very heavy. And I think they're worth the money totally. Number five on the list is my scent of the day. And again, I've been waiting to wear this one. A lot of these, most of these I picked up this year, bar a few. And yeah, it's my scent of the day, can finally wear it, and it is one of the most gorgeous scents in my collection. Not only does it smell incredible, but the bottle is just phenomenal. And that is Atelier des Soeurs Lune Feline. And the reason why this is such a gorgeous bottle is you actually have the gold flakes in this one. And yeah, I am wearing this today, and it's a little bit similar to Nashane Annie, but I would say it's heavier on the vanilla and it's more smoky. The closest to this, I would say, is Replica by the Fireplace, but this is a lot more complex and yeah, it lasts longer and it just feels more luxurious and rich. So the note breakdown in Lune Feline are top notes, cardamom, cinnamon and pink pepper. Middle notes, ambergris, styrax and cedar. And base notes are Tahitian vanilla and balsam. And this is a very, very special scent in my collection. If you like By the Fireplace, you definitely need to try this, because this is its more luxurious and long-lasting sister or brother. So yeah, that is number five on the list. Number six on the list is something that's been in my collection for quite some time. I don't actually have a full-size bottle at the moment, but that is none other the Tom Ford Tobacco Vanille. And this is in the 10ml travel atomizer. I quite like this because you can pop it into your purse. Not much left in here. And this is one that I'll always go back to again and again and again. And there are similar fragrances out there, but for some reason, this one I just think is pretty supreme. So Tobacco Vanille, as the name suggests, is a tobacco and vanilla scent. So this is like the fourth kind of vanilla-y scent in the list so far, so you can see there's a trend of what kind of scent profiles I like for the full time. But yeah, Tobacco Vanille, the note breakdown are top notes, tobacco leaf and spicy notes, middle notes, vanilla, cacao and tonka bean, and base notes are dried fruits and woodsy notes. And it's just really sexy. So the tobacco is not like a smoky tobacco scent, it's a really realistic kind of sweet tobacco, and then really vanilla-y and lots of tonka in there. And yeah, whenever my mother comes over, she's always spraying herself in this one. She absolutely adores it. So I'm sure a lot of people have smelt this one, but yeah, Tobacco Vanille has to land in this list because, like I said, I always go back to it. So for some reason my camera just stopped filming and I'd already talked through a few of these other ones, but I'm just going to keep rolling. So seventh on the list is one that's still within the vanilla theme, but it takes a slightly different approach. This is one that I would wear all year round, but I think it will be absolutely beautiful in the fall. And that is none other than Poets of Berlin by Wilhelm. Now, I actually wanted a full-size bottle of this, but it had been sold out in the UK for quite some time. So I managed to get this 3x10ml bottles in a set. So I have 30 mils of it. And it's actually really handy because I can pop it in my bag when I'm traveling. But yeah, Poets of Berlin is really, really gorgeous. It's still a vanilla, but it's more of an aromatic green vanilla with some fruit notes in here. And people perceive this one very differently. So a lot of people can pick up kind of like a blueberry muffin note in here, or it reminds them of a blueberry muffin, which I don't personally get. I actually pick up a cigar note in here, which is not in the note breakdown, but yeah, that's just what I get from it. So Poets of Berlin is really gorgeous. It is notes of blueberry and lemon, middle notes bamboo and orris, and base notes vanilla, sandalwood and vetiver. And this one I just think is ultra classy. You can wear it all year round, and I'm really looking forward to wearing it this autumn. Me personally, I think this is one of the best from Wilhelm, and if you haven't smelt it, highly recommend you check this one out. Eighth on the list is one that you may not have heard about because it's relatively new to my collection and not spoken about. I haven't really seen many people speak about it at all, if anyone. And that is a brand called Alexandra J, and this is Imperial Peacock. This is actually a Harrods exclusive, but how luxurious is this bottle? I think this is absolutely breathtaking and will look great in anybody's collection. Very, very different and very high end. The packaging, the outer packaging of this was absolutely ridiculous in a good way. It was so luxurious. It was a real kind of opulent moment opening that up. So yeah, Imperial Peacock is a vanillary scent, but it's definitely very gourmand. And again, you can wear this all year round, but I think personally, this will be best in the fall and winter. It's very, very unusual. It's very sweet too, but it has this nice kind of woody tonka base, which pulls it back a little bit and makes it a little bit less sweet. And I just think this is so delicious and very, very sexy and very appropriate for the season. So top notes are rhubarb, almond and heliotrope. Middle notes are vanilla or black vanilla husk, tonka bean and cinnamon, and base notes, woodsy notes. And it's really hard to describe what this smells like because I personally haven't ever smelled anything like this. But if you like the sound of that note breakdown, so like the rhubarb, almond, tonka, wood and vanilla. If you are near London, I definitely recommend going to Harrods and checking it out. This will make you feel like $1 million. And the bottle is, I don't know if you can see, but this one's actually got peacocks on it. And yeah, I just had to include this one because I'm really looking forward to wearing it more this season. So yeah, that is Alexandra J, Imperial Peacock. So ninth on the list, we're continuing on that kind of gourmand theme. It still has vanilla throughout it, but definitely an autumn or fall winter fragrance. And this is actually another Stefan Humbert Lucas fragrance, and that is Sand Dance. And again, it's in this beautiful bottle. I honestly can't wait to wear this. I've worn it once so far and I just knew it wasn't right for the season that I tried it in. And this is just so appropriate now for the cooler weather. And have you ever tried the drink, I think they call it an Irish whiskey or Irish cream. Not quite Bailey's, there's a different version of it, but it smells like a whiskey in like a cream liqueur. It is so delightful. And you can imagine drinking that on a really cozy day, either sat by the fireplace or you're in like a pub or something like that. It is just so delicious, but it's not too sweet at all. If anything, it's more kind of spicy, but with an added sweetness. So the top notes are whiskey and coriander. Middle notes are cacao, sandalwood. And base notes are benzoin, tonka bean, cedar and patchouli. And I can't wait to smell this on other people too, because it is very unique again. It's nice and boozy, but it's also a sweet boozy, but not overpowering like some of the other ones on the market. And Yeah, Sand Dance is going to be a hit, I think, this autumn winter, and I'm probably, well, I think there'll be more people speaking about this coming soon. So, Stefan Humbert-Lucas, Sand Dance for my 9th pick. Last but not least, and in 10th place, I have spoken about this one way too many times, and I don't want to bore you with it, which is why I popped it in last. But this is the season to wear it. I have been waiting, and that is Kilian Angel Share. And if this isn't a full scent, I don't know what is. It is apple pie, spicy apple pie. It is really sweet. So if you've ever smelt it in a store or on a test strip, you might have been like, oh, that's maybe too sweet and sickly. But I promise you, pop this on the skin and it will take you in a completely different direction. The spices come out, it's more warm, it's more boozy. The sweetness is nice, but it's not as overpowering as just smelling it from the bottle or smelling it on a strip. And Angel Share is just a no-brainer in my opinion. I think it was in my top five video, but I'm not sure. And the bottle, again, is going to look great in anyone's collection. You could put this on your vanity or wherever you like to store your fragrances. So, top notes are cognac, middle notes, cinnamon, tonka bean, and oak, and base notes are praline, vanilla, and sandalwood. And if the notes don't get you intrigued, I don't know what will, but I highly recommend getting your nose on this one. And yeah, if you probably haven't noticed already, I definitely have a theme of what type of scents I love to wear in the fall time. They are mostly all vanilla scents, but they all take different directions. So some of them are really spicy, some of them are more gourmand, some of them are smoky, and then there's a couple of fruity ones in there. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed my selection. I am super interested in what your favourite fall autumn scents are and which ones you will be gravitating towards this season. Have you tried any of the ones I talked through and do you like any of them? Or do you dislike any of them? And that's absolutely fine too. We all have different fragrance tastes and I love to hear your opinions. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed that video and found it useful. Again, I'd appreciate it if you could subscribe to my channel. I'm trying to create this content and it would be really good if you could help and support me. So I'm looking forward to making more content for you. I hope you have a great day and thank you. Bye bye.